known attack when you have a date or mark the start of the time of the Vikings.
Right, right, I see.
And that's just on the other side of the North Sea in England.
Yeah. Yeah.
There's a small monastery on a small island called Lindisfarne.
Right.
And one of the monks, he would write a letter for the English king. He wanted protection against the evil, evil heathens.
Oh, yeah.
And he would write something like this.
Yeah.
It was in the year 793. In spring, have there been dragons with the thunder in heavens. Yes. Something you would look upon, and it meaning that evil thing would happen.
Right.
And exactly the 8th of June at sunup.
Yes.
And sunup, the 8th of June is 5:18 in the morning.
Right.
So therefore, we have the exact time the Vikings came. And they killed the holy men in the church. The blood fled around in the church, and they were stealing the holy books and the silver, and took many holy men with them as slaves.
Oh, wow.
And as thin as possible. And very thin planking and very huge Frisian horses is not the best
combination.
So therefore they start building the boats bigger, wider and higher, for giving space for horses. And then you would lose speed and agility. And to give you a better position to fight, you build towers in the stern of the ship, and then it's no longer a Viking boat.
Yeah, right.
The last time a fleet of Viking boats is in battle marked the end of the time of the Vikings.
Oh, yeah, right.
And that's a man called Wilhelm. Wilhelm the Bastard comes from Normandy in France, and in the summer of 1066 he would attack England with 200 long ships. In this summer, there's many fights going around in England. Also, there's some Norwegians coming in and attack from from north. And they have a battle at Stamford Bridge, but it all ends at the Battle of Hastings, the 14th of October.
Right.
So that's tomorrow. Yeah. This boat here is a replica of a Norwegian Viking ship. The ship's name is Havørn, the Sea Eagle, and Havørn is the original ship is called the Gokstad ship, and you can see that in Oslo in the Viking Ships Museum up there. Was a river in the 8,000 years ago.
Oh, that was a river.
Yeah,
okay,
it was only a river.
Everything close together.
So you can walk
to England.
To England, yeah. Bloodstone, where you bleed the blood is you bleed the animal on the stone,
right.
And then the animal is giving to the gods. And in a half circle here we have some of the most important gods from the time of the Vikings.
Right, yeah.
And I think we could set. I would talk about this one here. This is Frey. It's very have a very distinctive leg there. If you see a Norwegian or a Nordic god with such a big thingy there, it's always Frey.
Okay.
Frey is maybe the most important of the old Nordic gods for normal people. He is the farmer's god. He's the god that keeps the good living. Swines in the stables, the cow giving milk, plenty to eat, your children don't have to be hungry. Silver in your purse.
Mm.
A good rich life is Frey to make this.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And Frey has also given the name for Friday.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. In the German language they say Freitag.
Yeah.
In the Danish language we say Freitag. So Frey have given the name for Friday. Somebody losing the story after it would be the victor.
Yeah.
But in this time this was the losers.
Yes.
There was riding the story.
Yeah,
but the Vikings they moved in and they they moved to other countries, and they took up the local what you call it, a mix of a drugstore and a camping place. If you're going to be honest, most Vikings, they were farmers, and they were living home at the farm. They would use the long winter to make some craftsmanship. In spring, they would you have a fireplace, and the women are cooking, and the heart of the heart of the house where all living is. On the other side, we have the bathroom, and it's called the bathroom, but it's the chieftain's sleeping quarters. But it's the only place in the house where there's a wooden floor. So if you have to bathe inside the house, then you have to bathe in the chieftain's sleeping room. In the Iron Age, they had the Romans, and the Romans have made beautiful ways around Europe, but we have no Romans here. So we have no road. The only road to God is the sea. And Denmark is also as simple as one country in the time of the Vikings. That's the sailing.
Yes.
That's simple Denmark. Memory of his mother Gyll, and Gyll had got the hammer Thor.
Oh, there you go. Yeah.
So it's been on those.